All right, guys, I've been trying to make this video for a few minutes. We are in a 150-year-old house that has been completely gutted. And drywall. We're fixing to first coat it. I'll show you how we first coat the house as we go. And then when we come back in to do the woodwork, I'll show you that. I am putting this on my main channel instead of the second channel because I ain't got time to run two channels. I'll show you some footage of the house prior to the drywall where it was gutted. I'll try to add some of that in, but we're gonna get started rolling this house. Stay tuned. You look at the old beams, they're true 2x12s. Two by fours are real 2x4s. You see the old slats that hold the plaster. As usual, one of my guys goes around and knocks out all the dust in the corners. The reason for this, so when the spray hits it from the sprayer, it don't leave a bunch of paint globbed up with dust. It only takes a few minutes and it works wonders. Okay. All right, guys, as usual, I have one of the guys after we've dusted all our corners, run through with our sprayer, and we spray all our angles with our ceiling white. So much faster than using a brush. That's how my dad raised me, using a brush. We'd walk on stilts with a brush, but still, so much faster. Got the drywallers here finishing up a little bit of sanding before we can roll. Looks like they put a heavy skim on the ceiling. That is funny. So guys, I'm gonna tell you a funny story about this fella right here rolling his ceiling. The other day, his butt crack was showing. Should I tell him, Jamie?
No.
Oh my goodness. He put his underwear on backwards that morning at home and wasn't paying attention. It was hilarious. Oh, I won't tell nobody, Jamie.
Yeah.
So, of course, guys, after the house is cut, then we go back with rollers and we roll these ceilings. Gonna get them all rolled once. I'm gonna go back with a sprayer, cut them all again. Then we're gonna roll the walls. And then at the very end, we'll come back and hit these ceilings again. That way they're full, two coats on the ceilings. And when we come back for the second coat, we don't gotta fold the ceilings again. Plenty of paint up there. You wanna really seal this drywall up good. So that second coat does a fine job. You get the gist about how big this place is. It's only, with the little basement, it's only 1,905 square feet. So there's not a lot of footage here, but it's gonna be super nice once we're done. All right, guys, all the ceilings are first coated. And all the corners on the ceilings are sprayed twice. We're gonna roll all these walls. And as soon as these ceilings are dry enough, I'm gonna go and start second coating them. That way they're done. We don't gotta get back on them except for touch up. Check this out, guys. This is the old foundation of the house. They had to bust part of it out. And of course, put new foundation in for the new part. So down this wall here is all new foundation. These ceilings down here are barely 7 feet in the basement, but this is all new foundation wall down through here. All right, guys, here in the entry, we're gonna be putting a gray looking color. What's it called, Jamie?
I don't know.
gray looking color here in the entry.
Bluish gray.
The door there, we're not sure what they're doing yet, whether they're tearing it out or putting a new one in. And then the brick around the door. Not sure if they're gonna maybe do decorative wood around that. So when we do rollouts, if we just got one little room, we'll just bring a 9-inch roller from the shop instead of using 18. This is literally just this, that wall, the wall right here up by me, and then the that return right there. Hey guys, while Jamie's rolling this, I want to show you something. This is a block of wood that is nailed to the door. That block of wood, there's another one. And up there's another one. That's what's holding this door in place. Because this house has two layers of brick. There are no, there is no framing in this house. It's literally two layers of brick. It is amazing. Guys, something I wanted to show you is these floors are standing on, let me see if I can't zoom in there so you can see this. You can see outside right there. You see that 2x12 right there, or 10? It's supposed to be inside that brick. You can see outside right there. That lets you know how far out this wall has moved over the last 150 years. It's kind of scary that I look at it like that. All right, Rob is in here first coating the dining room, what will be the dining room. So this is, we'd be considered the dining room. I want you to look at this light, guys. Look at this old thing, this old chandelier. Obviously it was the dining room 100 years ago because there's the old chandelier. But we're only putting one coat of paint on this room and the room over there because it's gonna get wallpaper. On top of this paint, we'll put sizing and then wallpaper. But just to keep the dust down, we go ahead and first coat the drywall because these are some dusty places when it's all fresh drywall like this. All right, guys, ceilings are done. All the walls are rolled. Now Rob's on stilts. This is how we get them done fast. Jump on stilts, jump up there, and just start cutting. He's cutting the top. Jamie's got the blue cut. Now Jamie's working on these corners with this lighter color. We'll be out of here shortly. Pretty easy day. It's not a very big house, so I only brought two guys to this job because, again, it's only like 1,900 square feet, so there's not a lot of floor space here. But I'll try to put this video together and show you some of the old parts of the house prior to all this drywall getting hung. And if you have any comments or questions about this video, please put down below. And if you haven't, subscribe if you could. Let out.